So for those who have heard me earlier, how many of you have heard me earlier? Yes, I see a couple of hands, so that means still I have some content which we shared with others. Okay, so welcome, I would say evening to all of you. Workplace devices, when I say, okay, what does it signify to all of you? Any guesses? Okay, so we are going, one step ahead, okay, of the traditional, devices. Sorry? Great, okay. So dedicated workstations, which we also call as the stationary workstations, right? Great, okay. And so on? Laptops, okay. Absolutely. Okay, so you're exactly on the point. Okay, so we also call them by the name of client computing devices. Okay, so in Fujitsu's terminology, okay, there is something called as DC, which includes your storage, servers, and then the third, business line, which is the client computing devices, which includes your laptop, desktops. It includes special dedicated workstations. Okay, when I say dedicated workstations, it involves two aspects to it. One is your stationary workstation, which comes fully loaded with the graphic cards, okay, and other high performance computing stuff inside it, and as well as the mobile workstation, okay, which you can carry it. Then, apart from this, we also have some solutions which are centered around the CCD product line, which is your thin client based solutions. We have known by the name of Futro thin clients. Okay, Fujitsu Futro thin clients. So, but before actually going into the presentation, okay, I would just like to ask you a very plain, simple question. Okay, it's a very normal question. Throughout the presentations today, okay, there is one thing, okay, which I have commonly observed, okay, which has been at the epicenter of every presentation, okay, and there is one element, okay, in this entire ICT, I would call, okay, information and communications technology, okay, which is at the epicenter of all these discussions, okay, which is that one element. Digital, okay, security, okay, these are all aspects which are centered around that. Exactly, you got it. Who's that? Okay. This is the only, only thing, okay, which we are talking of. Everything is revolving around, this data, right? Be it storage, okay, everybody is trying to, playing around that data in terms of how to process it, how well to process it, okay, and how to add value, okay, to the existing process, right? When it comes to storage, okay, how to save this data, okay, in what kind of formats, okay, and in which ways to retrieve it, okay, what are the different mechanisms, okay, to really retrieve that data, okay, is this data going to be secure, right? So that brings us to the open discussion. Now, whatever data, okay, we are exchanging today is all limited, right? It was limited, let me rephrase my statement. It was limited, okay, over a period of time. But now, this data, okay, is far going beyond boundaries. It is now traveling along with you and me. Am I right in making this statement? Can somebody elaborate it more quickly? Exactly. Okay. So when we refer to real-time data, just one simple example of it. Okay. We buy online, right? Okay. There is an auction going on, or there is a sale going on. Okay. So for 100 mobiles, okay, which are being sold, okay, on a particular date at a particular time, how far is the guarantee that you will get that 100 mobile? case. It all happens in a real time. Okay, but this is in this entire journey. Okay, how do we really ensure that this entire data is secure? What I was trying to make you understand is, earlier this data was very restricted within the organization, but now this data is traveling with humanity, across legal boundaries, going beyond boundaries, I would say. How is that? You have your mobile device. Even I have my mobile device, right? Smartphone. With that, I'm carrying my entire organization in that small device. Because I can sitting over here in this room, my mails are finished off for the day till around close to 5:45 or maybe 5 o'clock. I don't have any mails to be read or replied back. So that's the kind of things which are evolving. So in making that statement, definition of IT security. So how do we really define IT security? So it has to be these three terms: confidentiality, availability, and data consistency. So the data has to be consistent. It has to be available at all times. With you. There should be no hindrance. In terms of availability of the data, due to various troubles. That you come across. In terms of confidentiality, this is something very important. Each and every organization. When I make this statement again, if you see the next slide, helping hackers hit the jackpot. So if you see over here the figures, it is quite alarming. 39% of the malicious cyber attacks are the result of negligence, including the password theft. Today, just imagine, one single mistake we make online, and it can result us, with so much of losses. $3.579 million average cost of security breach, to an organization. Average, $200K annual cost of difficulties logging on for a 500-person company. And so if you notice the last one, which is also something very discouraging. At any moment of time, this is something which I keep on telling my wife. Tomorrow if something happens to me, what will happen? In my laptop, if I have to really tell you, there are at least for that matter 50 passwords, which I carry at any moment of time. Are you really secure if tomorrow something happens to me? Right? So we are not really, there was one message which popped up, I think couple of days before on WhatsApp group. What a nice video it was. Kotak life insurance. So I'm not here to brand that product, but then very nice video which was designed. So the guy was traveling in a bus. Suddenly they showed that he was about to meet with an accident, and within that fraction of a second, the things that you just imagined were very disturbing. Within that fraction of a second, that guy could realize he had a daughter, he had a wife who had to be taken care of. He had his parents which needed to be taken care of. But then in this entire exercise, are we really secure throughout? Is something which is very alarming. Many end-to-end attack points. So if we see today, these are few of the attack points which we normally can come across in our day-to-day scenario. Internal data, your HDDs, SSDs, DVDs, through which we can get these cyber attacks. Your screen contents, which at times may be visible to others, and they can really make it an attempt to hack it. Your passwords, your details, webcam and microphone can be, if at times decided, it can also be one of the medium to hack your information. Your main memories, which is a non-volatile memory something which is really not being thought of, and of course all the peripheral devices. So these are very, very minute things which we really don't pay attention to at any moment of time. We just take it for granted. Am I right? Let's understand. how Fujitsu's client computing devices, okay, help, okay, in terms of, you know, overcoming few of them. So first is of course the hardware based protection. So let me repeat quickly again. If you see over here stylistic, like both mobile, Kudros, Esprimos and the Celsius. Celsius represents the workstation. Esprimo our desktops, Kudros the thin clients, the Lightbook notebooks, okay, which we have, and the stylistic notebooks. Okay. So this is the complete, and these are few of the access mechanisms, okay, which from a software defined platform, okay, we have, you know, access given rights to the users. System protection, hardware based. Okay, we have something called as hardware based, okay, your Kensington slots, okay, and so on. Plus there are some, you know, hardware devices also which are there. Access protection, pre-boot authentication. Now this is also very important. People normally give security to the systems, okay, post the operating system comes into effect, right? But there is something called as pre-boot authentication also, which is provided on most of our devices except for the Fujitsu thin clients. Workplace Protect is a software which is being provided with most of our client computing solutions and absolutely free. Okay, absolutely free. Okay, so this is something, okay, which is very encouraging. Not many people know this, okay, but these are few of the softwares, okay, which we provide along with our machines. Palm Secure is something which I am going to talk in detail quickly. Workplace Embedded Tools. And finally, if you see, there is something called as Erase Disk. I am sure there are people already from the government organizations in this room, right? You need to also encounter this problem of getting rid of the HDDs, okay, after 5 years or 7 years down the line. Am I right? Right? When you take out your old machines, HDDs are something, okay, which are prime most important. Right? How to really, you know, take care of that concern? We have something called as Erase Disk. Okay, again a firmware based, you know, application which runs up to 32 rounds of passes of zeros and ones on the sectors of your drives. There is no guarantee that any hacker in the world, okay, can retrieve back the contents of that drive. And plus a guarantee that original hard drive can be again used back, okay, in your environment, IT environment. Okay. So it's a very useful, you know, firmware based feature, okay, which comes along with the Fujitsu workstations. It also comes along with our Lightbook notebooks. Finally, HDD based encryption, both hardware based as well as software based encryption devices. Okay, so these are few of the, you know, things which are there provided along with the products. Something which is very unique to Fujitsu. Before I go on to that, okay, presence sensor. Now this is also very important. Okay, we also have certain TFTs, okay, which are unique patent applied presence sensors. Okay, so if you are not there in front of your system for a defined time, the system automatically comes to a halt position. Okay, so again a very uniquely patented, you know, technology. It saves energy and protects your valuable data. Okay, when you are not in front of your system. Okay, quickly on the next part, Palm Secure. How many of you are aware, okay, of this technology? Okay, very few. Okay, I must say. But this is a unique patented technology of Fujitsu which is now being offered, okay, on our most of our Lightbook notebooks. Okay, even though a very uniquely patented technology and comes, okay, in a very, you know, small form factor now. Earlier it used to be like, you know, you have to have a separate mouse kind of a device, okay, on which you know show your palm, okay, and you get access to the system. Why it is so much effective as compared to your normal iris scanner or for that matter your fingerprint sensor is because it is 1000 times secure, okay, than those kind of devices. The reason being, okay, even among two identical twins, okay, the palm pin patterns, okay, are quite different. And this is something, okay, which this system identifies very well. Okay, and is quite different, okay, and very advanced as compared to the technology part. Okay. So this is something, okay, which has become the, you know, buzz of the, you know, now. This is how it operates. Okay, it takes advantage of your veins, okay, through the infrared light which comes, okay, out of that device. Okay, it captures your palm wing patterns, okay, and saves it either on the smart card device which comes on your device, okay, on your say stationary machine, or it gets saved in your network, okay, in your data center. Okay, so if you want to have your own security, your local security, you save your, you know, palm wing patterns on the smart card device so that nobody else gets the access to your own device. So, the moment you show your palm, the next thing that it will ask you is you insert your smart card and you get access to your machine. What used to earlier happen is, you remove the mouse, okay, the mouse which used to come with the palm bend, okay, device. If you remove the mouse, okay, you can easily get access still to the system. But with this mechanism, if you insert the smart card device, only then, okay, it will give you an access. Okay. So, very uniquely patented technology. It comes with our LiPo notebooks, most of our top end, the higher end advanced, and the superior series of notebooks. Okay? If you see that. So, this is how it looks like. If you see that square device, okay, on the right hand side of the notebook, it looks like that. Okay, very small miniature. The previous slide? Not sure, okay, whether it, yeah. I think this one. So this is, if you see over there, okay, it is compared to all other, you know, face recognition, voice pattern, fingerprint, okay, iris retina scanner, okay, and how many times it is, you know, far better in terms of comparison. So if you compare it with iris scanner, okay, it is almost 1000 times secure, okay, than that.
What is FAR and FAR?
Sorry?
What is
FAR and FAR? Failure ratio. Okay, so it is called as failure acceptance, you know, ratio. Okay, so how many times, okay, given an attempt, how many times it can fail? Okay, so it is that. Okay. Failure rejection ratio. Okay, acceptance ratio and failure rejection ratio.
So with the time period, the palm wins or wins in.
Sorry? So throughout your life, okay, your palm wind patterns remains the same.
No, exactly. My child who is 5 years old is using his palm,
right?
When I talk.
Yeah.
So when he go outside and wind came, after means initially when he, my wife and Canada, then go and after it came, then what happens? He put the palm over there. Means not palm there, at that time I have fingerprint. So, when you put this thumb over there, this is not visible by my laptop. So,
sorry, I didn't get your question. Can you repeat again, please?
Means with the time period of age, so palm means with the remains same. Means this pattern remains same.
Pattern or remains the same. Visible? Pattern remains the same. Okay. Even if you don't have to take any risk, okay, you keep on changing the patterns. Okay, it doesn't really matter. You can keep changing your pattern after every 6 months, okay, or 1 year down the line. How far does it matter? Okay, it's just a matter of, I would say, matter of just a minute, okay, to save that, okay, on your smart card device, okay, or your, you know, in your data center. Yes?
Actually, you were asking, how long this
There is no change, okay, in your wind patterns. There is no change, okay. I can take this question offline, okay, and I can explain you. There is no change, okay, to this. That's why I said even among two identical twins, okay, it is quite different. Okay, chances are very high that, you know, fingerprint, okay, might sometimes, you know, give access. But this kind of a mechanism absolutely is a school no. Absolutely. So that's what I said, okay, ideally it doesn't change, okay? But if you still want to don't take a chance, okay, you keep on changing it. It's just a matter of a minute, okay, to scan and, you know, save that data. Yeah, you have that option, okay? You have that software which comes along with the device, okay, which is called as Earthless Protect, okay, which is available with you all the time. Yeah, it is removable. It's just like your what do you call it, credit card device. Credit card, yeah. Sorry? Absolutely no, not at all. You know, they are not harmful at all. Okay, just your normal infrared rays. Yeah.
Okay. So what are the
biometric, you know, technology.
So what are the other batteries we consider apart from analyzing the palm vein and see? We have interpreted things machines or whatever you call it. We can easily do by using zero or something. So is it consuming any other batteries or just analyzing the pattern? Because that can be played for finding or showing something or what in my opinion. So
it is very unique. That is the reason I told it is very unique about two identical twins also. Okay, so you really can't do that kind of a jugglery over here. Okay. Fingerprint it can be done. Yes, at any moment of time. This. Exactly. Okay. So yeah. Okay. Over here, there is one more advantage. Okay. I'm actually jumping. Okay. On my time over here. But over here. Okay. This is one more important aspect. It is contactless. Okay. And at the same time, you know, one important thing to be noted over here is, you know, your palm vein patterns. Okay. Are lightly, you know, captured. Okay. The blood flow. Okay. Inside your body. Okay. Is lightly captured. In the moment a person, you know, gets dead, okay, all this complete, you know, system comes at a halt. And the very next moment, if a dead person, okay, if you have already have the access, okay, for that person, and you scan it, okay, with the palm vein sensor, it will not give you access. Yeah. Okay. So. These are, you know, few of the devices, the newly launched Lightroom notebooks, okay, which we have, okay, which now come
with the Last question.
Can I take it offline, sir? Okay. I have some content, you know, to be shared.
Okay, no issues.
Please, I'm sorry. So, these are the new devices, okay, we call it as the ultrabook notebooks, okay, which now come with these type of technologies, okay, the palm vein sensor technology. Average weight of these notebooks is just 1.15 kg. Okay, can be positioned, you know, to the top of those of the organization or the mid-level management, you know, kind of. They also come with, you know, same series port applicator. So if you have port applicator, is also referred to be as a, you know, docking station. Okay, we call it as a port applicator, and it comes with inbuilt features like 4G, 3G options, and so on. Okay. There is one more, okay, series in this, which is Lightroom E5 series. Okay, E547 and E557, which is newly launched. 547 is your 14 inch and 557 is the 15.6 inch. Okay, so this is the... No, it has a wired charger. So we are going to, you know, announce that also. Okay, it will come very soon. Okay, so as you know, I'm not sure, okay, whether you attended the morning session. Okay, we have almost around 97,000 pigeons today. Yeah. Out of which, okay, closely around more than half, okay, of those patents are with us, and the remaining have been filed. Okay, so then you can imagine the USB 3.0, okay, which you use it day in day out, is Fujitsu's patent. Okay, so you get paid royalty for. So quickly, okay, going on. So this is the, you know, workstation portfolio. Let me not get into the depth of it, okay, right now. But I just want to, you know, take you through a snapshot of it. Something which is more important to know is the industry's smallest, you know, workstation, which is a virtual ready workstation, is the W570, recently launched, and we are now coming up, okay, with two new workstations, okay, in this series. I'm just, you know, jumping on this slide right now because I already have overshooted my time. So this is something okay, which is top of the town. Okay, it's going to be almost $60 billion industry in the next one decade. Okay, virtual reality. Okay, so you can in a live environment. Okay, you can actually feel okay a part or a component of a car okay being manufactured and how it gets fitted into the final product. Okay, so gone are those days okay where you used to do 2D drawings okay, 3D drawings okay, and then working on AutoCAD and so on, right? So a scenario is now going to arrive okay, wherein you can actually live environment okay, you can actually feel the product okay, how it looks like and how it finally gets fitted into that final you know composed product. Okay, so with the help of VR. For this one, so for this there is no
because
such.
Because the auto industry uses a lot of these protocols.
Okay.
DLM.
Okay. Then cosine. Okay. No, but over here there is nothing you know to do with those protocols over here. Okay. What this kind of technology normally requires okay, is there's a separate software which comes okay, along with this okay, device. Plus, you have the you know head mount displays which comes from HTC Vive and Oculus Rift. Okay, which comes as or you can take it locally also. Okay, over here. And plus, we have our you know specially designed workstations which come bundled with the Pascal series of graphic cards, which has now made it possible with the help of you know CUDA programming. Okay, so this is something okay which is okay made the new you know virtual reality from a dream okay to a reality. Okay. This is the new workstation okay which is going to get launched okay very soon from next month. Still under NDA, but I just wanted to you know show you. So Celsius M770. Okay, in terms of security, we ensure that okay, this workstation now also has a front lock okay, to be given to the users. Again, whisper quiet machines, okay, 20 decibels of noise levels. I'm sure people must have you know discussed about noise levels. Okay, 20 decibels is almost negligible to human ear. Just imagine workstations okay, with like I would say 4000, P4000 or P5000 kind of a graphic card. Imagine the amount of noise that it makes, okay, when it actually starts performing. Okay, but then we have you know workstations which only generate up to 20 decibels of noise. If somebody is really interested in knowing, okay, you can contact me, I will help you explain okay the architecture behind you know each and every product. Okay, how it is made possible. This is the final look and feel okay of the Celsius M770. That's a single processor workstation. This is a dual processor workstation, okay, which is getting launched. Breaking all barriers okay in terms of you know personal supercomputing. Anybody in this room okay also involved in deep learning process or has heard about deep learning, machine learning? Okay, so yeah, people okay interested in okay that product can really you know go in for this kind of a product. Deep learning, the CUDA course okay is something which is important okay for you people. This machine has got that power. Okay, of coming with Tesla cards, also with your the high-end compute cards. Okay, so this is that machine. Okay, and finally, okay, in a nutshell, advanced solutions. Okay, like the unique palm secure, the latest generation of the you know biometric authentication technology is something okay which we have now started offering on each and every of our product line. Okay, not so expensive. If you ask me in terms of the price points comparison. If I have to offer it on a lightbook kind of a you know notebook, it will cost additionally some 3,500-4,000 rupees. Okay, but then just imagine the kind of security that you will provide okay over the years. Okay, similarly, remote authentication is something okay which we also you know provide as a value add to our customers. Okay, please whenever you buy okay these products, also you know you utilize all these other. Security softwares which are provided okay along with the devices okay, and I'm sure okay they will definitely add some more value to your business. Okay, so with that I will stop my presentation over here. Already shooted up my time. Okay, if somebody is really interested okay, in asking further more questions, I'm available. Okay, why? Because I think there's already been an arrangement needs to be made. But before that, there's a small presentation from my friend about scanners. Okay. So we have document scanners, okay, which we sell in our country. Okay, they are also being stocked in the country today. So as and when you have requirements, okay, here is the man, okay, who is going to talk about this product line. So you have Rohit Grover.